Welcome to the 2021 award final event for the South Central Virginia and Albemarle Bay CFC. This year we honoured 60 years of the CFC by taking a look back through the years. It was President Kennedy who formalised the CFC with an executive order in 1961, and for 60 years the CFC has been a strong tradition for federal employees. Hi everyone, my name is Julie Dudley and joining me today is Christy Kennell. Together we are the Associate Directors for the Zone.
Thank you, Julie. Today is going to be full of thank yous, and to start us off, we would like to thank our local federal coordinating committee. The LFCC is comprised of local federal employees who are instrumental in helping us implement the CFC program, recruit campaign workers, and keeping agencies and commands updated. Captain Hewitt from Naval Station Norfolk, along with Commander John Newhart, head our LFCC. They are responsible for numerous additional oversight and coordination tasks. Their support and leadership were integral to our success this year. Thank you both. And thank you to the entire LFCC for being change makers. Now, on to the fun. To our federal volunteers, some of you are CFC veterans and some of you are newcomers, but all of you embody the heart of what it means to be a public servant, going beyond your service to join our caring community. We all work in different corners of the zone, and yet we have come together to support the causes that matter most to us. To the change makers who donated, pledged volunteer time, shared their story, and served in the campaign, thank you. You each have shown your dedication to a cause bigger than yourself. And thanks to all of you, the federal workforce, for demonstrating that we are a community of change makers. You have raised over $1.4 million. That is incredible. And we have numerous federal employees committed to volunteering their invaluable time. This year, donors pledged over 1,000 volunteer hours. Together, your efforts will bring help and hope to millions of people. As monetary and volunteer pledges go to support the mission of thousands of participating charities, please give yourself a round of applause. Today, we wanted to provide you with a quick update on our campaign year numbers and key accomplishments. As of today, we are projected to raise over $1.4 million. This is a 2.4% increase over the dollars raised in 2020. There were over 1,000 hours of volunteer service donated back to the local CFC nonprofits. We held 22 leadership briefings, trained 472 campaign workers, and we hosted 72 events with 27 charities and more than 35,000 federal employees in the zone participating in these events. Thank you to all for being part of these incredible accomplishments. We are so excited to celebrate some outstanding individuals, teams, agencies, and installations for their contributions to the 2021 combined federal campaign.
Before we get started announcing our 2021 awards, we want to take a moment to recognize our national winners from the 2020 campaign year. When nominees are submitted for awards at the local level and selected as winners, they are sent to the national level as award nominees. Let me introduce you to our 2020 National Award winners. Karen Brown from USPS Richmond, the Heroes Award. Karen has a real passion for the CFC, as most USP workers do not have access to computers during work hours. Following COVID protocols and safety regulations, Karen collected over 201 paper pledges in person, raising over $89,000. Joyce Ortiz, NASA Langley Research Center, the Innovation Award. NASA has a great strategy to keep employees engaged by facilitating internal awareness events and keeping communication rolling throughout the campaign. Joyce spearheaded the communications developing the messaging, strategy, and facilitating all internal events by leveraging Microsoft Teams to focus on all employees' attention in a virtual platform. Given all the issues of 2020, NASA Langley Research Center managed to raise over $264,000. Lieutenant Shalene Sawyer, Langley Air Force Base Hero Award. Using the Air Force core values of integrity first, service before self, and excellence in all we do, Lieutenant Sawyer's dedicated efforts and enthusiasm for the combined federal campaign garnered Langley Air Force Combat Command with a 45% increase over 2019 and a 67% increase in donors. Let's take a look at our 2020 local zone winners, beginning with our individual award category. So, okay, here we go. Our first award is the CFC Service Award. The Service Award recognizes a key worker or volunteer who made the most valuable contribution in their agency, contributing to the overall success of the agency's campaign. Virginia volunteered to serve as the campaign executive secretary for the 2021 combined federal campaign at NASA Langley Research Center. She coordinated and scheduled weekly meetings, recorded all meetings, and downloaded typed and prepared weekly CFC meeting minutes. She kept a list of key workers for all departments, distributed the CFC newsletter and calls of the week to all volunteers on a weekly basis, and fielded all questions to keep the campaign managers focused. She prepared all individual certificates of appreciation for NASA's key workers and emailed each one with a personal thank you note. Lastly, Virginia has volunteered to serve again as the executive secretary for the 2022 campaign. Thank you, Virginia. Grace Smith is based at Fort Eustace and volunteered as a key worker. She went above and beyond by taking on the responsibility of keeping leadership and other personnel updated on totals on a weekly basis. She personally worked with units to assure 100% contact and also ensured employees were aware of how to give and the various ways to contribute. Thank you, Grace. Chief Johnson served as the 2021 co-campaign manager for USS Harry S. Truman. Chief Johnson was responsible for strategic planning and implementation of the CFC, ensuring over 4,000 active duty personnel aboard ship understood the benefits of the CFC and provided each with the chance to participate through monetary donations or volunteer hours. He ensured leadership remained engaged and aware throughout the campaign with constant communication and progress reports to include reporting personnel contact rates in accordance with the CFC guidelines and USN regulations. He also spearheaded the marketing campaign on board by ensuring CFC promotional materials were distributed throughout the command, maximizing CFC awareness. His utilization of the CFC toolkit is his frequent communication with the entire crew created a sense of urgency around the campaign and was instrumental in the success of the campaign on board the USS Harry S. Truman. And our winner. Another big thank you to Virginia for all you have done in the service of the campaign. Congratulations, Virginia Morgan.
Our second individual award is the Atlas Award. Locally, we award three winners, and each individual is submitted for OPM National CFCO Hero Award. A CFCO hero is a person who implemented a successful CFC and went above and beyond the call of duty in service to the campaign. We had a few great nominees this year, and we are grateful for every one of you. But here are our winners. Award winner number one is Ms. Karen Brown from USPS. Karen has been the campaign manager for over 5 years for the Richmond VA Distribution Center. As one of our top campaign managers year over year, Karen has a real passion for the CFC. As most USPS workers do not have access to computer terminals during work hours, following COVID protocols and safety regulations again this year, Karen collected over 201 pledges in person. USPS employees have donated over $75,000. Thank you, Ms. Brown. Award winner number two is Chief Chase Talent of the USS Harry S. Truman. As co-campaign manager, he was responsible for ensuring over 4,000 active duty personnel aboard ship understood the benefits of the CFC and provided each with the chance to participate. He anticipated the needs of the ship, thereby recruiting, motivating, and leading 23 key workers. And due to the limited number of computers versus the number of personnel on board, Chief was instrumental in working with the Command Religious Ministries Department in designating computers in the ship's library as a CFC donation computer in order to maximize donation opportunities. The USS Harry Truman to date has raised over $6,000 in donations for charitable organizations to help those in need. This is an increase over 100% from 2020 and 89% over 2019. Thank you, Chief Talent. Petty Officer Hare served as the 2021 campaign manager for both United States Coast Guard Base Elizabeth City and Station Elizabeth City. As a junior petty officer, he coordinated strategic planning and execution of the CFC program for 900 active duty and civilian personnel routinely managed by a commissioned officer, lieutenant, or above. His actions were instrumental to the successful recruitment of 5 campaign workers and proactive communication of CFC benefits and solicitation across both installations. In keeping with the United States Coast Guard's core values of honor, respect, and devotion to duty, Petty Officer Hayer's enthusiastic efforts and commitment to the combined federal campaign garnered United States Coast Guard Base Elizabeth City to date over $8,000 in donations for charitable organizations, an increase of over 44% from 2020. Thank you, Petty Officer Hayer, and congratulations to all three of you.
First up for agency awards is the third award of the event. The Show Must Go On is our outstanding event recognition. This award recognizes campaigns that put together an impressive event or more that inspired during this crazy most virtual campaign. The VA Medical Center Hunter Holmes McGuire brought awareness to the campaign with a pandemic still being at the forefront of employees' day-to-day. Acting Director Mr. James Dudley set the example by contributing and dressing as a superhero and supporting the manning of a booth in their foyer. Booths were manned by key workers continuously, using a cardboard cutout of Mr. Dudley and a barometer. With employees working shifts, the impact of the pandemic, teleworking, and an increase of patient workload, the campaign managers created a virtual event where 3 charities from different causes were invited to participate and tell their story. Employees could participate in the live session or view the recording at their leisure. Over 3,900 employees were provided with the opportunity to view the virtual event and to participate by asking the charities or CFC staff member questions. It has been a busy, overwhelming year for the VA Medical Centers, and the leadership and campaign managers embrace the challenge. With leadership actively involved and participating in a fun way that increased awareness for both co-workers and retirees. NASA Langley Research Center entire workforce has been teleworking for over 2 years. The campaign planning team and leadership were all in this year. Their level of engagement was high, and this translated to positive morale for the employees. Despite the continuing pandemic, this year's campaign goal has surpassed and more than 274,000, which was donated by NASA Langley Research Center employees. A committee team of leadership and employees is formed in May each year, headed by the nominated campaign manager. In August, the committee begins planning to include securing key workers, selecting additional leadership, laying out a communication plan, and creating awareness events. Each person plays a vital role, which is key to the success of the campaign. Virtual events being key to success involved IT becoming a part of the campaign for virtual support and was vital. The committee found that virtual platforms have made an impact and their value is immeasurable. They continue using virtual events in the future to maximize participation and provide fun, informative awareness for the campaign. And our winner is the fifth award goes to federal agencies and one installation for achieving outstanding CFC results. This is achieved by utilizing innovative and creative campaign methods, motivating campaign workers, creating awareness of the CFC, and demonstrating leadership support. Defence Supply Centre Richmond, Defence Logistics Agency aviation employees have been working remotely for the past 2 years. For some, COVID-19 means packed days of in-person meetings have turned virtual and therefore run minute to minute with literally back-to-back meetings. Campaign manager Christy Duke has taken over the position for over 10 years. And she knew that all employees teleworking, new key workers would find the position challenging. 31 key workers from previous years volunteered and were assigned to units. Over 3,000 employees were given the opportunity to participate. The campaign managers and leadership worked on a more strategic in-house approach for the 2021 campaign to bring CFC awareness to employees by bringing CFC virtually to the forefront of employees. The campaign managers produced virtual events built around CFC content, attendee interest engagement, data, and CFC staff participation. Additionally, campaign managers worked with key workers to provide virtual fun and information emails with great reasons to give, how to give, the cause of the week impact statements. Congratulations, Defence Supply Centre Richmond, as our top 2021 agency. With renewed combined efforts across commands, Naval Station Norfolk had another great year, with many still working remotely, on shift or night hours, or ships at sea. It became logistically challenging to make sure everyone was given the opportunity to participate in the CFC. Working with command campaign managers and utilizing our electronic communications with toolkits and social media, campaign workers were able to pass along information to all employees. leadership took in a role disseminating all information regarding recruitment of campaign workers and support of all efforts CFC related. Congratulations, Naval Station Norfolk, as our top 2021 installation.
Our last and final award is our Beanstalk or Exceptional Growth Award. It's a numbers game. Final 2021 campaign results are compared to 2020 results, and agencies and installations that demonstrate exceptional growth will be recognized. We want to celebrate growth for agencies and offices who have been successfully raising donations throughout the years, as well as those who have re-engaged this campaign year. We have three separate categories based on the number of personnel within an agency, and we'll be awarding two in each category. We have large agencies which have 1,000 personnel or more. We have medium agencies that have 100 to 1,000 personnel, and small agencies that have fewer than 100 personnel. Let's start with our small agency nominations. The Department of Agriculture Forest Service raised over $3,600 during the 2021 campaign year. This was an increase of 202% over 2020. Thank you, U.S. Forest Service. The Department of Defense, the U.S. Navy's Lewis B. Puller, came back full force with over $8,000 in donations for 2020. This is an increase of 100% over the past 2 years. The Puller team did a great job. Thank you, USS Puller. The Department of Treasury Internal Revenue Service has consistently raised thousands of dollars over the 3 years. This year, they've raised over $13,000, increasing by 180% over 2020 and 7% over 2019. Thank you to the IRS team. The Department of Justice, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, has also had an amazing comeback this year. Also consistently raising thousands of dollars each year, the FBI raised over $11,000 during the 2021 campaign. This is an increase of 342% over 2020 and 174% over 2019. Thank you, FBI team. This is our last set of awards, so our large agencies. And our first winner is the United States Postal Service, as they underwent many changes in structure during the beginning of the campaign year. They worked overtime to make sure everything went smoothly during the restructure and stayed consistent in their campaign plan. Raising thousands of dollars each year, the USPS raised over $81,000 during the 2021 campaign. This is an increase of 8% over 2020 and 2% over 2019. Thank you, USPS. The USS Harry S. Truman raised over $6,000 during the 2021 campaign. They have been working incredibly hard to make sure each shipmate had the opportunity to participate in the campaign, as you saw with our earlier award nominations. Thank you, USS Harry Truman.
We have pleasure in introducing Charles Boland, Office of Chief Counsel, NASA Langley Research Center, with a thank you message to the Zone.
Hi, my name is Pete Boland, and I had the privilege of serving as the Executive Chair of the Combined Federal Campaign at NASA Langley Research this year for 2021. It was my honor to serve with a great team of civil servants and contractors who helped organize the campaign. And with our core team for the CFC and our key workers, we raised awareness about the campaign, highlighted charities throughout the campaign, and encouraged our employees to give. And our generous employees at NASA Langley pledged over $275,000 to the campaign this year. So to all of you at NASA Langley, whether a member of the team, a key worker, or you've generously pledged to CFC, thank you so much. That means a great deal. And to our employees, our civil servants and contractors and military members from across the South Central Virginia and Albemarle Bay region of the CFC, for 2021, if you led a team, if you participated in a team, you helped organize campaigns, or you volunteered in some way or served as a key worker, thank you so much. We would not have had the successful campaign that we did in our region this year without you. You helped make 2021 successful for the CFC in our region. Thank you so much again. And to our great employees, our great civil servants, our great contractors, our brave military members, all of you who serve at the military commands, the federal agencies, and at the federal entities within our region, if you gave to the campaign this year, thank you so much and gave through your pledge. It means a great deal. Obviously, our campaign means nothing if you don't pledge, and you do, and you have a giving heart, and you showed it this year. Your pledges in our region exceeded $1.4 million this year. Your desire to help others is evident through your pledges and your willingness to volunteer as well. You're helping charities who help people in need, not only in our region, but across the United States and across the world. You know, our campaign theme this year was to be the face of change, and your generosity just shone through and helped us make that campaign theme a reality. You all are truly the face of change for so many people this year. Thank you so much. You're paying it forward to people in need who will receive the benefits of your pledges to those charities this year. Not only will they receive it this year, but they'll receive the benefit of it from years to come. So thank you so much for your generosity. It means so much to so many.
Thank you to all federal departments, agencies, and offices of the South Central Virginia and Albemarle Bay Combined Federal Campaign. Congratulations on running an outstanding and well-rounded campaign and helping those in need. We hope to see you again in the upcoming campaign season. Have a great day, everyone.